Hi, Lean Goddess. It's Katie Wygant here, and I want to show you some ways to save time and teach you how to enter your food in an online meal tracker. So the online meal tracker that I love is fitday.com, F-I-T-D-A-Y.com, and you can set up a free username and account and simply log in the upper right-hand corner. So if it takes you to another page other than the homepage that looks like this, it means you are not in their classic view. In the upper right-hand corner of their homepage, you'll see a button, a tab that says Classic View. I suggest clicking on that so that you get the old view, which I like to work with, but you can do what works best for you. This is your homepage. You know it's your homepage because it's your food tabs. The disadvantage to FitDay is that there's a lot of extra junk on the website that you don't need. There's a ton of different tabs here. I don't mess with them, so don't be distracted by having to enter more information than you need. And also, they do have a lot of advertisements, but if you can ignore that and block it out, you'll be good to go just using this right here, the food log, and then we'll also show you the pie chart. So you can simply search for food. So let's say you ate an apple today, or you're planning a meal plan for tomorrow and you want to eat an apple. You would search apple, and I hit the word raw after it so that it propagates it first in the column here, apple raw. They have all sorts of different types of apples. Look at all those apples. There's tons of pages. So we're not eating pickled apples. Those sound gross. So we're just going to have a raw apple. I just add to food log and it adds it to the log. So let's say I also ate an egg, or I want to eat an egg tomorrow on my meal plan. Again, egg, I hit raw. Even if you cook it, it still measures the same. So add to food log, egg raw. Here's the amount. Here's the unit. So this is how I measure it, whether it's cups, ounces, or the size of it. That's how I measure it. And the calories, fat, carbs, and protein. So those are the three macronutrients that we are tracking here. And you'll see that in the pie chart. So this is the pie chart of the total calories here, 143. So far, 49%, almost half of it is coming from carbohydrates, 33% of it's fat, and 18% of it is protein. But we're only working with 143 calories. So once we get a full day's worth of calories, you can play with changing the percentages to meet your daily needs. So instead of every day just searching for food here and adding one at a time, after you have food entered, you've tried it for a couple of times, it's going to save everything in your recent foods. So right here on the left hand, this is my easy go-to section to save time. Recent foods is everything that I have eaten or added to a meal plan in the past. And custom foods are all foods I've custom entered, and it'll save it forever. So knowing that, I can just click right here on View My Recent Foods and simply scroll down and click all the foods that I ate today if I'm meal tracking today, or if I'm planning a meal plan, I can plan out all the food I want to enter. So I'm going to click a few of these for demonstration purposes. I want spinach, I want my fish oil, zucchini, and scroll down, let's see, some onions, protein powder. All right, and then add checked items. So there you go, it adds it all to your meal tracker. I didn't have to search one at a time, so I do this first if I'm going to plan a meal plan or track what I ate. I always check my custom foods and my recent foods to see if there's anything I can easily add. If there's other items I need to add, then I just search for them at that time. So once I have all the food entered for the day, then I go back and change the amount and the units of measurements. So let's say I really ate 2 eggs, then I would change that. And let's say I had 2 cups of carrots and 2 tablespoons of olive oil and 2 servings of protein powder and 6 ounces of onion. And let's say I didn't want to measure it in ounces. Let's say I wanted to measure it in an onion. Let's say I ate 1/4 of an onion. I would go 0.25. You need to do it in decimal form. So that would be 1/4 of an onion if I wanted to do 1/2. Or if I did ate a lot of onion, 0.75 for 3/4 of a cup. But I did 0.25. So then I click save and it'll recalculate my total calories, grade 1496. And what I love, love, love about Fit Day is this pie chart, because if you're visual, this makes it really easy to adjust your calories for planning purposes. If you know your macronutrients, the protein, carbs, and fats, the percentages that you're trying to hit of your total calories here, this is going to be your best friend. So if I'm at 43% fat, 20% protein, and 38% carbs, and I wanted to be higher percentage of protein, let's say I wanted to be at 30 or 40% protein, means I'm going to have to find more protein sources to hit those numbers. So maybe I want to do just egg white if I want to bump that up. So egg white, again, you can hit raw and it'll probably, here we go, egg white. I mean, you can hit cooked, you know, whatever you find. It's not going to change the numbers that much. But 1 large egg white, I measure my egg whites in cups. So let's say I do 1/2 cup of pure egg white and repopulates. So bump my calories up, but it bump my protein up too. And the other thing is awesome. So if I say, I see it's at 41% fat and I definitely want to be around 30%, I can just scroll up to the fat here and say, wow, where's most of my fat coming from? Oh, 2 tablespoons of olive oil. Well, that's ridiculous. I just want 1. Save changes. It's going to bring my percentage of fat way down to 36. I think it was at like 42 or 44%. So that's quite a drop. Also dropped my calories, but that's what's fun, is you can start playing around until your pie chart hits the macronutrients that you need to hit. And it'll save this information forever. So it will be in recent foods. Let's say you want to enter a custom food here because you have your own protein powder, or you found something that is not showing up in your search engine, then you want to create a custom food. Really, really easy. We only are tracking our macronutrients. So let's name our food Lean Goddess Protein. And I want to do 1 scoop because I put the measurement so I know, and it's 200 calories. Let's say it's 7 grams of fat. And let's see how many grams of carbohydrates. Let's do 13 grams of carbs and 25 grams of protein. Hit enter or create this food. And there you go. It's your Lean Goddess protein powder, 1 scoop. And double check that you entered it in the right columns, because sometimes if you don't, it'll definitely show up in the wrong columns and you'll wonder why your numbers aren't making sense. Then simply click to add to your food log and it'll repopulate with the protein powder in there. So it brought our calories up to 1640. Our pie chart's looking much more balanced at 37% carbs, 35% fat, and 27% protein. So that looks good. So it'll save this Lean Goddess protein in my custom foods. Again, I use my recent foods tab here, And the last thing I want to show you is this. This is your calendar. So let's say you entered food yesterday or last month and you wanted to see what that meal plan looked like. You can simply click on the date. It'll take you to a month overview. And anytime you hit enter food, it will show an apple here highlighted foods. So yesterday I entered foods. I click on it and you can see what foods are there. That looks great. I can click back on the calendar overview. You can see it changed to the calendar tab and brings me to the 4th. And here's my total calories. So again, what I love is this pie chart. It makes it really easy for planning ahead and making sure you're just fine-tuning your food to hit your numbers. And also, just this quick and easy resource button here on the sides, the recent foods and custom foods. You can do a printer-friendly version if you want to just print it out, share it with your coach. You can use this view here. So that's what I got for you. Again, don't be distracted by all the other tabs unless you want to go gung-ho or the advertisements, but you might find it useful. This is what I use and always recommend for my clients. Find what works for you and be sure to subscribe to our YouTube page, Lean Goddess. Check us out on Facebook, and thanks for being part of our community. Until next time.